Hey. Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Bands too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, your sex OD. You got it, girl, you got it. Hey. You got it, girl, you got it. Yeah. Pretty little thing, you got a bag and now you wildin'. You just took it off the line, no mileage.
What's up, everyone? I'm back with another video, and I'm going to be talking about ADN program versus an ABSN program. This was a highly requested video, so let's get right into it. So first, we're gonna start off talking about the ABSN program. An ABSN program is an accelerated bachelor's of science in nursing program. So this program is for anyone who has a bachelor's degree in any other study than nursing. So you can have a degree in biology, chemistry, psychology, finance, business, art, design, dance, whatever you want. But as long as you do not have a degree in nursing. So you can't have your degree as an LPN or an RN because that's considered nursing. So an ABSN program is basically for people who decide to change their career. So you can be working, say if your degree is in finance and you're already working in your field and you just say, hey, I wanna go for nursing. This is the program for you. Also, I find the ABSN program perfect for people who are in college and already getting their bachelor's degree. And like now it's just too late to change your major or too late to transfer. This is for you too, because that was me. So you're like halfway through your degree and you're like, oh no, it's not worth it. If I transfer, it's gonna push me way behind. You can just graduate with that major, with that degree, and then you just go along to an accelerated program. So the cost of an ABSN program is a little bit pricey, a lot of it pricey. So the cost of an ABSN program can range from between $40,000 to $80,000. So that all depends on if it's like a private school or it just depends on what like the school's tuition is. Also guys, sorry if I'm like looking down because I have my notes on this. Like I did my research because I want to give you the most accurate information that I can give. So there is an application fee and also there is a non-refundable deposit for the program. So if you get accepted into the program, you have to pay a non-refundable deposit that's usually about $500, could be more, like I said, all depending on the school and their requirements. So that non-refundable deposit has to be paid within that week of acceptance. Also, what I've read is that, which is a good, really good thing, that some schools take that deposit and put it towards your first payment of, so the first quarter that you have to pay. So that's a good thing too. So my problem with the ABSN program, I don't know if this was anybody else's problem, but the issue that I had was I could not get financial aid. Like I couldn't get it. I mean, they would give it to me, but I couldn't accept it because I already have a bachelor's degree. This is what I was told. I already have a bachelor's degree. So basically, they were saying that I maxed out of my student loans for my undergraduate degree anyway. Because you have to think that ABSN program is still an undergraduate degree. You're getting your bachelor's degree in nursing. So because it's considered an undergraduate degree, I maxed out of my undergrad loans. So that means that I would have to pay down my student loans in order to accept more money. How much am I gonna have to pay down in order to accept the cost of this program? So, but that was just my issue. I don't know if anybody else had this problem, but that's just something to think about as well. Questions to ask. The requirements of an ABSN program. As I mentioned before, one requirement is you have to have a bachelor's degree, any study other than nursing. That's the first one. Also, you have to have a 3.0 GPA, And for most schools anyway, not all schools are just strictly 3.0. Also, you, for most schools, you have to get in your prereqs a B and above. So anything a B and above, you'll meet that requirement. So as for the prereqs, this is tricky because every school is so different and they require different prereqs to be completed before the program. But I'm going to list the most common prereqs for almost like all programs require these prereqs. So you have AMP 1 and 2, you have microbiology, you have some form of chemistry, whether it be general chemistry 1, general chemistry 2, organic chemistry, biochemistry, you have nutrition, and you also have some form of psychology. So some programs may call it something different and it may be the same, or some programs may require a different class overall, but most likely it's some form of developmental psychology. So whether it be lifespan development, which is what I have, or developmental psychology, some programs even call it developmental psychology across a lifespan, I don't know, but some type of developmental psychology where it studies from the beginning of life all the way to the end of life. And like I said, programs are different, so you have to really like reach out to the programs and try to see what they require. Because for instance, I talked to a program where I had nutrition, and they were like, do you have nutrition with a licensed nutritionist? And I'm like, I don't know. So those things, like really dig in and do your research on these schools, because every school is so different. Also, some schools require some form of English. Most schools require College Comp 1, so like an English 1. Also, some schools will throw in their genetics, some schools will throw in their ethics. So like I said, just keep checking the requirements, because you never know when they'll add something or when they'll change, or you don't want to go through the whole process and then just get the run around and they're just like, oh no, but you have to have this class, or you know, so just keep checking. Now, the length of an ABSN program, that varies as well. So you have some programs that range from 11 months, and then some programs that go up to 24 months. So that also depends on the school. Also, the programs, most ABSN programs are depending on the length. So whether it's 11 months to 24 months, most programs are all year round. So when I say all year round, I mean they have summer sessions. So you'll have summer, fall, winter, spring, summer, fall, winter, like however long up until that the program point. So if it's like 11 months, you're gonna do spring, summer, fall, and that's it. So program intensity, I am not in an ABSN program, so I can't really say how intense it is, but I heard that it's very intense. There's some people, the recruiters of the programs that I've talked to, and they're like, so you can't work in this program. Like, you can't work at all. It's that intense. So I'm like, okay. Like I said, it just all depends. If you're going to do a 24-month program, it might not be that case. So they might allow you to work in a 24-month program. But the program I was looking at, it was 11 months, and they were like, yeah, no, you can't work. You have to just think about the fact that they're taking a four-year program because your bachelor's degree in nursing traditionally would take you 4 years. So they're taking a four-year program and condensing it into 11 months or 24 months or however long, 12 months. But you're still getting that what would be worth a 4 years of education. So it's going to be intense. I mean, it's not unbearable. I'm pretty sure you can do it if that's what you want to do. If you stay focused, you can definitely do it. And also, if that does not work for you, like an 11-month program does not work for you, then you have the 24-month program. So like I said, I'm sure it may not be that case for a 24-month program. So if you have like a family and you're like, something gotta give, you can probably do the 24-month program. And I'm not saying that it's easier, but what I'm saying is it's probably less intense than an 11-month program or a faster-paced program. So just do what's best for you, what's best for your lifestyle in that aspect of choosing how long you should go. Just do what's best for you. Okay, so now let's get into the ADN program. So what is an ADN program? An ADN program is your associate's degree in nursing program. So with this program, you'll ultimately receive your RN degree. So once you graduate with your ADN, you pass the NCLEX, you'll be an RN, but you won't have a BSN. You'll have an ADN. So let's get into the cost of an ADN program. So for an ADN program, the average cost can be between $12,000 and $30,000, okay? But when I looked it up, it stated that most people pay the around like $12,000 mark, $12,000 or $14,000, or it just depends. And like I said, it's the same thing with ABSN program. It depends on the institution you are going to. So for my program, there is no non-refundable deposit to be made. There is no application fee, but that's not for all ADN programs. Some programs, like one program that I looked up, it required an $100 non-refundable deposit for the program. So it just varies. You just have to look up what your school requires. So with my experience, I completed all of my prereqs that are required for the program. So they include all of that cost as well. So how much it would be for your prereqs, including the nursing program. So that's included in the average cost of the nursing program for an ADN. For me, I completed majority. I have like two left. Majority of my prereqs for that program. So for me, when my estimated cost would be like $17,000, where the school's tuition is $22,000, but I knocked off some change because I completed all my prereqs prior and I paid for those classes already. Also, another thing about community colleges, they offer a lot of scholarships. So you can take advantage of a lot of scholarships. So I feel like the same would be for me with the whole financial aid. I maxed out of my aid. So they offer a lot of scholarships. And then luckily for me, I work in a hospital where they are willing to pay for school. So look at my other video that talks about why you should be a PCA or work in a hospital before nursing school. They might pay for your schooling, okay? To be able to apply to an ADN program, the only thing you need is a high school diploma. But for my program, they would like you to complete your prerequisites. So their requirements is AMP 1, Chemistry 1, English 1, which would be like a comp, like a college comp 1, and a sociology. So if you are graduating from high school and you want to be an RN, all you have to do, well, for my program, I'm pretty sure it's probably something similar, but I don't know the exact requirements for other programs. But my program, if you're coming out of high school, they want you to take those prereqs, those four classes, before you apply to the program. You have to take those classes along with the next requirement I'm going to talk about, which is the ATIT's test. So I know most community colleges require you to take the ATIT's test, and that's just like a nursing entry exam, which I am currently studying for right now. And for the ATIT's test, the requirement is, for my school, the requirement is 58% to pass. I know another school that I looked at, the requirement was like a 66% to pass, but that's just their requirement in order for your application to be looked at. Of course, you want to be more competitive and score higher. So I talked to a nursing recruiter at my school and she told me that yes, 58% is what you have to, the requirement for the school, but the acceptance average is like a 77%. So as long as you score like a 77% or a 70 and above, then you're considered competitive. for the GPA requirements, for my school, it's above a 2.5 GPA for your overall GPA. And then for the science GPA, it's a 3.0. So I'm pretty sure most ADN programs are around the same average, like a 2.5 or above 2.5, and then 3.0 for a science prereq. But I know for my program, that's what the requirements are. Also, in kind of going back on the classes that you're required to take, so those are the classes you have to take in order to be able to apply to the program. But of course, you still have to take things like microbiology. You have to take your A&P too, but for my program, you are allowed to take those classes while you're in the nursing program. For me, I don't have to because I've already completed them, but they allow you to take. So if you haven't taken those classes yet, a lot of students that I was even in class with were already in the nursing program. So I would check your local program, your local community college that has the nursing program, and see if they will allow you to take some of your prereqs while you're already in the program. Okay, so the length of an ADN program is 2 years. So an ADN program, like I said, is your associate's degree. So most community colleges, you get your degree in 2 years. So it's the same with the ADN program, the nursing program. So you'll get your ADN in 2 years. Also, ADN programs are, they fall in like fall, spring. For the core nursing classes, like nursing one, nursing two, like your clinicals, that all happens fall, spring. The intensity. Nursing school period is stressful, okay? Nursing school is not easy. It's not like the easiest thing in the world. It's not the hardest thing in the world, and it's not the easiest thing in the world, but it can stress you out. The exams and clinicals and things like that, that can stress you out. But for the intensity of an ADN program, I mean, it's 2 years, so I believe it would be less intense than an ABSN program. So at least for an ADN program, you get to have like your summer. You get to have the summer off. You get to have that winter break. So it's just like your regular school. You have the summer break. You have the winter break. Whereas an ABSN program, you are like, you don't get a break. I think you get like my friend, she's in, she did an ABSN program. She's a NICU nurse. Shout out to you, Jazz. She did an ABSN program, and I think her break was like a week. So it's hard. I mean, nursing school is hard, period. But as for an ADN program, you get that break. So if you have like a family, or if you have like a bunch of responsibilities, at least you're not so like you have to be solely focused on like nursing school. Like, you eat, breathe, sleep nursing school, so it's not so much like that. But just like any other nursing program, an ADN program, if you don't maintain your grades, you're out. So that right there can be stressful itself. But the overall program, I'm not in it, so I can't really speak, but I believe it's doable, it's possible. So there it is. You have your differences, you have your similarities of what an ABSN program is and what an ADN program is. And also, if you have your bachelor's degree, you can also go to an ADN program. It's not a big deal. Watch my first video on my introduction of my journey, and I will explain that to you more. So guys, that is all I have for you today. As always, if I've missed anything, or if you want to add to anything, or if you have any questions, you know what to do. Leave a comment below, and don't forget to like, share, subscribe to my channel, and I appreciate you guys for watching.